नमस्ते लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन, इंडिविजुअल्स इन वेरियस डोमेन्स। सो फार आई वॉज टॉकिंग अबाउट फाइंडिंग द ग्रेटनेस इन योर सेल्फ और फाइंडिंग द सोल विद इन योर सेल्फ, कंट्रोलिंग एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ द माइंड body and soul, and taking into consideration the practical aspects of the yoga therapeutic practices and other various aspects from the philosophical and spiritual point of view, taking into consideration the classical dance form and classical music form being one of the 9 types of devotional aspect to make sure you go on the right path. And I have been time and again telling, take your own time, make yourself comfortable, do it thoroughly with that integrity, and have that single-minded focus towards that. Now, most of us have a question in our mind. Why are we doing this exercise? What is the end result? What is the point behind doing this? When I say end result, what is the goal cast? What is the aim cast? How do you define success? Whether it will be a success or a failure is again a question over there. It depends on how much effort you are putting towards that. This is not only very important for an individual to understand from the success definition point of view, but from the practical aspect of understanding the success definition. There is a saying, the success, when you are success, or when you are success, that's the starting point of your journey. That's the starting point of your journey, wherein you need to do a few more experimentations, helping the society to grow. That's what is the true definition of success. Understand this, ladies and gentlemen. And that is what is or should be the aim or the goal of an individual, whether it is in the classical dance form or the music form or individual approach, doing meditational practices and other things. Now, most of us have a question that are there any shortcuts to success? when I say shortcuts, shortcuts do not remain for a longer time. You have to understand this. Shortcuts do not remain for a longer time. In yoga practice or meditational practices or the classical dance or the classical music form, if we really see, most of us want success like this. That's not the case. Classical dance and classical music are two exceptional, pure and divine practice that takes you to the highest level. When I say highest level, to the highest level, you will have to understand this. This is for every dance practitioner, aspiring dancers. This is one of the first lesson that a teacher or guru should teach. Even in schools, for the students, even this is for the parents who emphasize on succeeding. They don't really look at the failure aspect. They want immediate result like this. This I am telling because this has had happened with me personally. But I never took my foot back. I always fought genuinely. I had put my efforts, but never thought about the result. Even these recordings, which I am doing, I am not really looking at the success rate or the failure rate. I am trying to convey a message to the people to make them understand true meaning and true definition of exploring and searching of what you are, what you want to be, within and outside of the world. Understand this. This is, in fact, much more easier for aspiring dancers to practice, because they start practicing at a very early age of 4 or 5, to my understanding. Unfortunately, this does not happen for an individual who is not learning dance. This is for the parents as well to understand. Any art form for that matter, be it drawing, be it craftwork, be it singing, be it Carnatic music, Western music, learning guitar, etc., etc., whatever it is. Please do not look at that word called success. Once you start looking at the success kind of thing, that point of focus or the focal point will be lost. In fact, this is what is actually like told in Vedas and Upanishads. Don't look at results. Do your job. Leave the rest to the world. They may accept, they may not accept. And this is what means internal journey and external journey. And this is what the Gayatri Mantra teaches you when you are doing that. Understand this. That is the reason why I will say there is no secret to success, but there is a system to success. The system works if you work it out. Working it out means going in a systematic and schematic way. The willing to work is only the secret. When I say willing, one needs to do it diligently, without fail. He or she needs to understand, why am I doing this? What am I doing? Am I following a systematic way? Am I having a scheme? Let's not look at the results, but let's keep the results in the mind, but not focused. Let us keep that aside. Let's try working out a plan, action plan. Let's have a scheme. Let's have a system. And this is what in Vedas and Upanishads, through mantras and tantras, it is taught. And from the individualistic point of view, it helps you when you recite. It reconstructs, realigns, and re-engineers your mind process and thought process at the subconscious level and conscious level. This I am taking furthermore to the advanced level from my previous video. I am explaining you in a very simple and crisp way what happens. I am not getting into the intricacies of whatever chakras that are there, or the 36 tattva. I am not getting into tattva shastra or mantra shastra or tantra shastras or these doctrines for Westerners. I am not getting into that at all. Okay? You have to look at your insecurities. How do you overcome that? Once you start practicing this yogic practices or whatever meditative practices, when you start questioning on the insecurities, you will get an automatic answer within yourself. Yes, this is wrong. This is the right approach. You need to go through this. Is what? It gives you that green signal. It allows you to understand. At the same time, in your fear and find drive in the part. At some or the other corner, you will find that fear in your mind that gets deviated, that gets erased off. Once you start practicing or do in a systematic way and schematic way, wherein you would be able to understand your approach, then you will not have any apathies at all. And then it will help you to be more self-driven. Understand that. Self-driven and self-reliant. It helps you that way. And the best part is, the passion is all around you. It energizes or awakens the passion in your mind. Once you are clear with your mind, that yes, this is what I need to do. And then it will give you clear-cut ways to get to that. And that develops and that gives you clear understanding of what are your hidden passions. And whole of it is stacked in and around you. When I say whole of it is stacked in and around you, whole of the energy that is there that you got through these practices of mantras, tantras, or whatever it is, it gets accumulated and you start using it. And it will be in and around you. All the fuel and energy, all the fuel that is what is called Shakti. And energy is resistance to take control over yourself. That needed is there in you. That is there already. But we are not igniting it. These practices helps you to do that. It is for you to lift it. Now, choice is for you to think whether you want to lift it, whether you want to leave it, whether you want to ignore it, being arrogant about it. No, I do not want. Fine. That's your choice. What do you do? Find drive in your own securities. You will be able to then find that innate and already there drive within you at a security level, highest security level. You will not have those inhibitions that, no, I cannot do it. Understand this, ladies and gentlemen. This is the most powerful. I'm telling you, it's really powerful. Once you start cultivating that in this world, in this universe, from the Vedic point of view, when you understand Prakriti and Purusha, aspect, I will tell you, it will give you the clear picture, and you will be full of clarity of what is the success, the definition of success, all about. Today, apathy is we have the wrong definition of success, and once we do not get any result out of it, we tend to break down. That's not the case, ladies and gentlemen. Understand this. Whole of this is a practical application, and one needs to understand in and out of it. I'm explaining in a lame terms. Thus, just remember one thing, find drive in your own doubt. Start questioning yourself. Once you are practicing this yoga practice or Gayatri Mantra or Tantra or whatever from the Asian subcontinent level, if Westerners understand Vedas and Upanishads, if Westerners are able to understand Gayatri Mantra, well and good. But understand this, you will be able to understand. Don't look at the technical jargons, let's not get into that. That's not, let's, if you want to understand those technical jargons, get in touch with the spiritual leader who can explain you much better. If you are learning anything pertaining to Vedas and Upanishads, mantras and tantras, please make sure you approach right person who explains you from scratch. From scratch, A to Z, or pin to atom bomb. Only then you do. Else, do not get into that. Hear to those hymns, Vedic hymns or whatever hymns that you are following. At the same time, try not to make it a biased kind of thing. Make it a universal truth. That's when you would be able to get the right kind of fruits. And this is the practical application, ladies and gentlemen. If you are into art and culture, fine arts and culture, if you are learning classical dances of Indian classical dances, it will be more useful for you, specifically for Westerners. For Indians, it's more easier to understand. However, the moment you take control over whole of this, the moment you differentiate between success and success and have a clear-cut understanding of success, clarity of what really success definition is, believe me, you just go on and on and on and on. You become an unstoppable leader in this universe. Thus, take away from this video, or the pointers for this video are understanding the true definition of success and genuine way of practicing yoga or mantra or tantra for Indian dancers, Indian society across pan India, for Westerners who are following Indian culture, Indian Vedic Indic culture. They need to understand from scratch, that is A to Z or pin to atom bomb. Only then you start practicing. If not, hear to the Vedic hymns. It will be helpful for you to get those positive energies within your mind. Thus, I conclude this video with a positive note. Stay blessed. Have a blissful life. Have a nice day ahead. Shri Gurubhyo Namah. May the Guru's grace be with one and all. Have a nice day ahead.